hospital after my daughter's surgery. It was a 7-hour surgery. And for a 4-year-old to go through a 7-hour surgery, the type of trauma that that has on your body, I can't even describe. But they rolled my daughter back into the room and she was swollen. Her eyes were swollen, her face was swollen. She didn't even look like my daughter. I didn't know who they rolled into that room. But the doctor tells us, you know, we had a successful surgery. We were able to remove her adrenal gland, but her recovery is gonna be hard. But because she's in the hospital, she's gonna have to move around eventually just so that she don't have any bed sores and that she don't get any clots. So I told them, okay. They said it was gonna take about 5 days for her to feel ready to do that. I told them, okay. After 2 days, my daughter, the anesthesia started to wear off and my daughter started to wake up a little bit. And she wanted the color. And at the end of her bed, there was a table with crayons sitting on it. And she said, Dad, can you pass me those crayons? I want a color. And me being her parent, I'm like, yes, sure, baby, I'll pass you anything you want to. You just got done having the surgery. Yeah, I can get these crayons for you. But when I went to reach for the crayons, I stopped. And I looked at Leah and I told her, you know, I can give you these crayons, but I'm not going to. And y'all should have saw the look she gave me. Like, this man don't know I just went through a 7-hour surgery. He just told me no. But I looked at her and I said, you know what, Leah? This is your moment to prove to yourself how strong you are. I know how strong you are. I know you're strong enough to beat this disease, but I don't think you know it yet. So if you want a color, you're gonna have to sit up and get these crayons on your own. And she started to wiggle in her bed and try to sit up. And she goes to reach for the crayons and she's reaching for it for about 3 minutes. And finally she gives up and she lays back down. And my heart broke. My heart broke because I knew I was not gonna give her these crayons. That I knew that if I took away this moment from her, she was never gonna know what she was capable of. Instead, I decided to cheer her on. I'm like, come on, Leah, you can do this, keep fighting. You can grab these crayons. So she said, okay. And she sat up again and she went reaching for the crayons. And it took her 5 minutes and she just dove for the crayons and fell back on the bed and she just started smiling. And that smile told me that she knew she was strong enough to beat this disease. And a lot of you guys have the strength to overcome whatever you're going through, you just don't know it. You need people to tell you just how strong you are. And I'm telling you, once you get the mindset that you are strong enough to overcome anything you face, you're gonna be strong enough to overcome anything you face. It's all a mentality.